Namaste, Satsriyakal, Tena koutou katoa, and happy 70th birthday, India! You know, I get a little confused. I was at Bhatia Samaj at Sri Sai Baba Samthan last week, and it was the 71st anniversary, and today it's the 70th, so India's got a year younger in the last week. I think I've worked it out, however. Can I acknowledge our High Commissioner and thank him very much for putting on this occasion today in the Gandhi Centre, and what more appropriate than to celebrate the 70th anniversary in a place named after Mahatma Gandhi, the man whose inspirational leadership led India to victory. Can I acknowledge members of the Diplomatic Corps who are here to celebrate with India today? Can I acknowledge my Deputy Mayor, Bill Cashmore, our Members of Parliament, our local board members, and Indian community leaders? I want to say just a couple of things, because I heard the High Commissioner say, we're not really giving speeches, this is a cultural entertainment. I just want to acknowledge how far India has come in 70 years to be a leading economic power in the world today, a country that is the world's largest democracy, and India has preserved its democracy against every challenge that has been put up. So let's have a round of applause for the strength of democracy in India. But I also want to acknowledge India as a good friend of New Zealand. And the relationship has been an excellent one everywhere except in the cricket pitch. Sometimes we win. Sadly, more often I think India is winning these days. But it has been a long-standing relationship. The first Prime Minister I served under, David Longhi, was a massive fan of India. And when a previous Prime Minister had talked about closing the High Commission, we made sure that that High Commission stayed open. And one of the first people that we appointed as a High Commissioner was Sir Edmund Hillary, who alongside our cricket players, I think, is probably the most famous New Zealander in India today. I should acknowledge in passing the loss today of Sir Colin Meads, who passed away in Tikawiti Hospital. And we remember a huge sporting icon for New Zealand. Can I also acknowledge the enormous contribution, and the High Commissioner mentioned it before, the enormous contribution that our Indian community has made to this country. We may be celebrating 70 years since India's independence, but you know that Indian cultural history goes back 5,000 years. And when we today have Diwali, we see tens of thousands of people come out and celebrate in public the festival of Diwali. And that's a very special time in the Auckland calendar today. And we see the richness of that culture celebrated on so many occasions. We see the hard work of the Indian community here in Auckland. And we see the strong family and educational values. So today, on the 70th birthday of India, I want to thank all of you for the massive contribution you make to our city and our country. Thank you so much for that. Can I finally go back to Mahatma Gandhi? Because as a young man, there were two people in politics that inspired me. That were international leaders, or had been international leaders. One was Nelson Mandela, and the other was Mahatma Gandhi. And I admired both of those men. And I admired them because they lived their values, they lived their vision, and they were inspirational about the countries they wanted to bring to true independence and democracy, and the world that they wanted to see as a better place. And as I watched some of the sad things that have been happening in the last week, the terrorist attacks, for example, in Spain, I think of what Mahatma Gandhi taught us, and he said that an eye for an eye will only leave the whole world blind. And it's that sort of vision and inspiration that our world desperately needs today. Thank you so much for the invitation to be here today. Have a happy 70th birthday and enjoy the rest of the day.